Ramayana Pranganam is located at a distance of 35 kilometers from Visakhapatnam, en route to Vizianagaram. Situated in a sprawling 15-acre expanse near Vizianagaram, Ramanarayanam Srimad Ramayanam Pranganam is accessible to everyone. Spread over 20 acres, built in the shape of a bow and arrow, Ramanarayanam Temple in Vizianagaram took more than a decade to build. Entire story of Ramayana is sculptured in three-dimensional for the most of lifelike experience in understanding Valmiki Ramayana. It is one of the few places in the world which has a Veda Pathshala which is run by TTD. Ramanarayanam Srimad Ramayana Pranganam is definitely a unique way of depicting the Ramayana, and the seed of the idea was planted two generations ago when late Sri Narayanam Narasimha Murthy, founder and chairman of NCS Group, conceptualized the temple to be as such, envisioned to be more than a traditional temple for people to offer prayers. The idea was to promote it as a spiritual center where people could see the scenes from Ramayana and take away the essence of human values from the holy epic. Choosing just a few scenes from the large epic was a challenge, and Sri Narayana Nageshwar Rao and other family members discussed with scholars on the subject across the nation, and then meticulously chose 72 important episodes from the epic to be converted into pictorial sculptures. Artisans from across the nation were enlisted to carve the pictorial sculptures with intense detailing carefully throughout. Creativity crafted the Ramanarayanam leaves an everlasting impression in the mind of beholder. Accessible by road through the theme park has started functioning since 1 year ago. It sees a footfall of thousands of people each day. More than 25 lakh pilgrims visited till date. With a glorious present, the future plans of Ramanarayanam are illustrious. These include expansion of current facilities to include breathtaking musical fountains and entertainment options along the lines of Sentosa in Singapore and Miracle Gardens in Dubai. However, keeping in touch with ethnic roots as well, a Gaushala is proposed to be set up as a sanctuary for cows, calves and oxen. With so much activity taking place in Vizag after the state division in two and the state government's intention to convert Vizag into tourist hub, Ramanarayanam is destined to occupy a niche position and iconic center sooner than later. Constructed by NCS Charitable Trust under the aegis of Narayana family, Ramanarayanam Srimad Ramayana Pranganam was inaugurated by His Excellency Sri Konijeti Rosaiya, Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, on 22nd March 2014. Tucked away in the remote corner of the city of music, Vizianagaram, 50 kilometers from Vizag Airport and 15 kilometers from upcoming Greenfield Airport, Ramanarayanam provides an awesome yet is a spiritual theme park with atheistic gateway to those seeking solace in spiritual experience. The very unique design and elevation of the Pranganam is bound to leave the tourist spellbound with experience, rich, cherishing and invigorating. When noble thoughts become great intentions and such intentions become a driving passion, marvels like Ramayanam are created. Spread over a sprawling 15-acre plot with lush green lawns and taking over a decade from concept to design to execution and to reality, and with the sweat and toils of hundreds of artisans and artisans across the country who are chanting away Jai Sri Ram, this magnum opus called Ramanarayanam could finally take shape and achieve its destined position in the annals of the history of the city of learning music and the historical city of Vizianagaram. This spiritual theme park is exceptional in more ways than one. The design of the Pranganam is based on our ancient architecture upholding the Hindu mythology. Since green color provides huge relief to the tiring eyes, this theme park is also home to the most exotic spread of flora and fauna, which also offers solace to the tourists, pilgrims, visitors. Ramanarayan is considered to be the holiest epic of Hindus, is undoubtedly the most popular and timeless epic read and loved by all. Lord Sri Rama, who had all along stood for human values, principles and ethics and never swayed in dharma, is the epitome for all Hindus across the world. Swami Vivekananda said, "No language can be purer, non-chastier, non-more beautiful and at the same time simpler than the language in which the great poet Valmiki has depicted life of Rama." Based on the great epic of Valmiki Ramayana, this theme park is the first of its kind in the country, having built entirely without taking donations. It is uniquely built in the shape of a bow and arrow as a two-story complex with many trees dotting the landscape. One section shows the sacred trees of Nakshatra Vanam, Narayana Vanam, Rasi Vanam, Navagraha Vanam, Vinayaka Vanam, Saptasrishi Vanam, Panchavati Vanam, Panchabhuta Vanam. These rare trees have been a part of Indian scriptures and some of them were especially brought in from across the country as well. While the park stays open from 10 a.m. onwards, it is best visited in the evenings. That is, when the entire area is lit up in the colors of rainbow, giving us the feeling as if the heavens have transcended to the earth below. Beautiful mega fountains along the line of the bow transform spectacle of indescribable proportions. The cool evening breeze rejuvenates you with a fresh burst of oxygen. And while you are here, do stop at the huge mandapam called Sri Sita Ramala Adhyatmika Kala Toranam, which performs Sri Sita Ram Kalyanam every month on the eve of Purnamasa Nakshatra, birth star of Lord Rama. Other special pujas and programs relevant to Indian performing arts take place on a regular basis. The entrance of the two-storied bow and arrow structure is from one end of the arrow, and the visitors are soon inside a centrally air-conditioned complex depicting a series of sculptures from Ramayana, vibrant in color, rich in emotions and full of life. The 72 laminated moldings were created by thousands of artisans from different parts of the country. They depict 72 episodes from the Valmiki Ramayana, which seems right from the beginning of the epic Balakanda to Yuddhakanda. Below each of the 72 exquisitely chiseled laminated panels, a bilingual English and Telugu explanations narration of the event above is engraved on brass plates, with audio support also being arranged for the benefit of pilgrims. Sri Abhaya Anjaneya stands tall in all its grandeur and splendor, which is 76 feet in height. While a traditional Vishnu temple is part of the complex, the Ramanarayanam is more spiritual than its religious. In fact, right from the time when work on the park began, artists from across regions and cities have been integral part of the project. The Pranganam is home to a huge library with over 1 lakh spiritual books, where visitors can browse through many texts and also attend the cultural events that regularly take place here. A meditation center for channeling inner peace. These temples of Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu and Lord Rama and his consorts goddesses Sita and 18 feet statues of goddesses Laxmi and Saraswati surrounded by exquisite colorful water fountains are some of the stops you should make in the Pranganam. Also look out for the 7 special fountains that are shaped like the 7 astras or weapons of Lord Rama, which are dotted across the arrow. A residential Veda Pathshala adopted and run exclusively by the Tirupati Devasthanam imparts lessons on the four Vedas along with regular curriculum. Approximately 70 children have already enrolled in this full-time year, 8-year and 14-year course on the Vedas and Upanishads. With thousands thronging the Pranganam every day, which has now become a cynosure for tourists. If you haven't visited yet, then do plan soon. Jai Sri Ram, Jai Sri Ram, Jai Sri Ram.